Hello students, today we will solve the practice set number 27. Under this, today we will see how to solve the questions which is given in our practice set. So the first question is rewrite the following using a letter. Rewrite the following using a letter. So what is the first statement? The sum of a certain number and 3. What I said to you, the thing which is not given to us, the thing or the information which is not given to us, that we have to take the letters from A to Z. Suppose let the certain number be. So how to solve this example? So here write, let the certain number be. How much? Let the certain number be, A. Okay, and therefore the answer of this question is the A plus 3 means certain. Sum means plus and certain number means A, and sum A plus 3 is its answer. So in that way we have to solve this question. Second, the difference obtained by subtracting 11 from another number. So here first statement what we have to write, let the another number be P, Q, R, whatever you have to take, that you have to take. So the difference obtained by subtracting 11 from another number. So here write, let the another number, suppose I took here P. So P, difference means subtraction, and here it is 11. So P minus 11 is the answer for this question. Okay. Then next it is the third question. The product of 15 and the another number. So here also you have to take, like the another number is the x. So the product of 15 and another number is equals to, you have to write in the statement. So here x into 15 and this 15 into x. In that way you can write. If there is a in between 15 and x, there is no sign. Okay, I had not shown any sign. So here multiplication sign is there if you are writing it as it is included. Then next it is a 4 times a number. 4 times a number is how much? 24. 4 times of a number is how much? 24. So for that, 4 times, let the number be A. Here you have to write, let the number be A. 4 times of a number means 4A. And is how much it is there? 24. So here this is the equation, 4A is equals to 24. So in this way we have to solve the first question. Okay. Now after this we will move towards the next question. Question number second. Find out which operation must be done on both sides. Both sides, which operation we have to do, that we have to find out of this equation in order to solve them. So for this question, how to solve this question? So here x plus 9 equals to how much given? 11. As I told you before only, what we have to do, we have to put the letter on one side only. So for that we have to subtract this 9. So what we have to do when we have to solve this example, here x plus 9 minus 9, this 9 we have to subtract, and this minus 9 have to subtract from both the sides. So here it is 11 minus 9 means what we had, we done it here, that is the, we done the subtraction from both sides, subtraction of 9 from both sides, and 11 minus 9 is equal to 2. In this way we have to solve the example. So for this question, what we have to write here, for this subtract 9 from both sides. Subtract 9 from both sides, that we have to write for this question. Okay. Now here x plus x minus 4 is equals to 9. So what we have to do here, x minus 4 we have to cancel. So we have to add plus 4 here, and 9 plus 4. So here for getting the answer, what we had done here, adding 4 both sides of equation. So here write, adding, how to write this now? Adding 4 to both side of equation, here written, adding 4 both side of this equation, right. Now the next third question is there, 8x is equals to 24. So here we have to cancel this 8 with x. So how to do this? So what we have to do here, to cancel this 8, we have to divide the equation, both side of equation, by 8. So here we have to divide it with 8. here also dividing with 8, x is equals to, you will get 3. So here what you have, it is not necessary to solve, only here write divide equation, both side of equation by 8. In that way we have to write its answer. Okay, now fourth, x upon 3 is equal 6 is equal to 3, x upon 6 is equal to 3. So here in this, when we have to cancel the 6 from this denominator position, we have to multiply this equation with the 6. So 6 get cancels with 6, so x is equal to 3, 6 is 18. So we got here answer. So what we had done here, we multiply both side equation with the, multiply both sides of equation, side of equation by which 6. In this way we have to write its statement. Okay, clear? This is our second question. Now for the third question, what we have to do here, value of given below are some equation and the values of the variables. Are these values the solution to those equation? Is these values are there, these are the solution of equation or not? That we have to choose. So I will show you how to solve this. So first equation is y minus 3 is equals to how much? 11. So here I will solve the y minus, you have to solve in the space which is in your textbook, and y is equal to what we have to put it here, 3 we have to put. And when I said to you, when the equation becomes balanced, then this value is value satisfy the equation. So here it is, suppose this is y minus 3 equals to how much? 11. Y's value what is given here? 3 is given. So here 3 minus 3 is equals to how much? 0. But here RHS what is given? 11 is given. Means it does not satisfy the value of equation. That's why here it is written no. Okay. Now the next. 17 is equal to n plus 7. Okay. So here 17 is equals to, what they gave us? 17 is equals to, 17 is equals to n plus 7. And which value is given? N's? 10. 10 is given. Okay. So here n plus 7 means n's value is 10. 10 plus 7 is equals to how much? 17. And it is RHS of equation. So LHS and RHS satisfies the value. So here we have to write yes. Okay. Now the next third example. In this example, 30 equals to 5x is given. 30 equals to 5x. Then here 30, and x value how much given here? 5, x value is equal to 6 is given. So what we have to do here, 5x value we have to find out. 5x is equals to, if we get the 30, then answer is what? It is value satisfied. So x value is 6 given. 6, 5 is how much it is there? 30. So when we solve the RHS of equation, we got it here LHS, and that's why it also, what happens here also yes, and here also yes. Now the next fourth example, m upon 2 is equals to 14. M value is equal to how much given? 7. So for this, when we solve this example, here is yes and here is also yes. When we put the value of m is equal to 7, so m upon 2 is equals to, when we solve this, we got it here 3.5. So 3.5, but here RHS what is given? 14. So this value does not satisfy the equation. Means it is not balanced in the equation. So here we have to write the example. So whenever you have to solve this example, first of all draw this box, and below the box each equation you have to solve, its answer you have to find out, and then here yes and no you have to write for this answer. Okay, after this we will move towards the next question. Question number 4. It is very easy. What is given at first? Y minus 5 is equals to 1. Y minus 5 is equal to 1. And we have to find its value. So here that value only we have to find out. Solve the following equations. So y minus 5 is equals to 1. So how to solve this? Y minus 5 is equals to 1. as in your textbook it is given. Then here y minus 5 is equals to 1 given. According to textbook, y minus 5, this minus 5 we have to add here, opposite number we have to put here, and plus 5, so y is equals to how much? 6 is the answer of it. Otherwise you can solve it directly, y minus 5 is equals to 1, so y is equals to 1, this minus 5 it will come here for the addition, and 1 plus 6, 5 is equal to 6 is the answer, y is equal to. Okay, note down this. Next question, so question number 2nd, 8 is equal to t plus 5, 8 is equals to t plus 8 equals to t plus 5. Okay, so in this 8 keep here as it is, and this plus 5 we have to subtract, so t plus 5 and then subtract minus 5, so 8 minus 5 is equals to 3, and plus 5 and minus 5 answer is 0, so t is equal to what we got it here, 3, or 8 is equals to t plus 5, so here 8 minus 5 equals to how much t, and answer is how much it is there, 3. So in this way we have to solve the example, it is very easy, you can solve it very easily. Okay, the question number 3rd, 4x is equal to 52, 4x is equals to 52. So how to solve this example? First of all, 4 we have to cancel from this side, so divide it with the 4, and here also 52 you have to divide with the 4. Okay, now here 4 get cancels with 4, here remains only x, and here when we divide 52 with the 4, 4 ones are 4, remains 1, and 4 threes are 12, so x is equal to how much? 13 is its answer. Next question, note down this, all of you simultaneously. Now question number 4, 19 is equals to m minus 4, so here write 19 equals to m minus 4, then we have to do addition here, plus 4, not only for this side, we have to add in this side also. Okay, so here 19 plus 4 we have to write in this side also, so here I will write 19 plus 4, so 19 plus 4 plus 4 minus 4 cancel, and 19 plus 4 is equal to how much? 23. So here it is the value of m we will get in this. Now after this we will take the next example, question number 5. Question number 5, it is also very easy example. How to solve this? So here p upon 4 is equal to how much given? 9 given. So when we have to cancel this 4 from this side, p upon 4, what we have to do here? We have to multiply this with the 4. So into 4 equals to 9 into 4, 4 get cancels with 4. So p is equal to 9 4 is 36. Is it so? Answer. Now question number 6. X plus 10 is equals to how much? 5. So with x which value is there? Plus 10, that we have to cancel. So plus 10 how we can cancel? By subtracting 10 from this. So here also do the subtraction. So plus 10 minus 10 equals to 0. So x is equal to plus 5 minus 10 is equal to minus 5. X is equal to minus 5 is the answer of it. Okay. Next question is the 7th question. M minus 5 equals to minus 12. So here m we have to put on one side of equation, minus 5 we have to cancel, so add it here, plus 5 equals to minus 12 plus 5. M plus 5 minus 5 value is 0, so not necessary to write, and 12 minus 5 is equal to 7, and we have to give the bigger number sign, so m is equal to minus 7 is its answer. Now the 8th example. In this example, what we have to do? P plus 4 is equal to minus 4. So P with P plus 4 is there. We have to cancel the plus 4. So subtract from this 4. So minus 1 minus 4. So P plus 4 minus 4 is 0. And minus 1 minus 4 is the 5. So P is equal to minus 5 is its answer. Okay. So in this way, we have to solve this examples from our textbook. Now all of you complete question number 1, 2, 3 and 4 today, and what problems are there that we will take in our next lecture. So today we will stop here only. Okay, all of you complete today's homework. Okay, thank you and have a good day.